And welcome to the next video, which is mainly going to go over my new build, which is Frostblades, and also a bit of how I'm doing in the league. So first of all, 112 exiles pure at the moment. We did sell most of our gear off though. We stripped our whole ranger, which most of it sold. We still have the bow and the quiver and some amulet, so most of the stuff already sold. But we did make quite a bit of money the past few days from selling items actually. Because most of the items I had did go up in value, especially the stuff on my ranger. I had the Fractal Thoughts, and this one's not gonna sell, but I had one with Lightning Arrow Enchant, which I bought for 5 exalts, sold for 12. The bow we bought for 5 exalts, I think you can see it in the last video, that one ended up selling for 18 exalts. So we did make quite a bit of money from flipping, and on top of that, since I didn't enjoy the ranger too much, we've just been doing Uber Elder on the miner as well. We had some pretty nice Watcher's Eye drops as well. So all in all, that's the money we had. I think also the majority of this is because I did sell my headhunter. So the headhunter itself I bought for 54 exalts and ended up selling for 66. So that's another 12 exalts profit just from the headhunter alone. Since this league, there isn't beyond the map device. So I decided to make a build that actually doesn't rely on headhunter. On top of that, a few other reasons for this build, why I went with Frostblades. First of all, the single target is pretty good. As far as I know at least, so I would be able to boss and map on this character. Frostblades, again, a skill that's pretty good for clearing as well. Now, I do have my reservations. I don't know how much I like it since it is still a melee skill after all, since you'll have to hit someone melee first before the projectiles chain outwards. But I do think overall, as a bosser and a mapper, it's one of the better builds. And then we also went with Eternity Shroud, mainly because now all our gear has to be Shaper, so it does give me some incentive to craft some really good gear for it, since Shaper gear on the market is not that available. So that's why we went to this build. Now we'll go over the gear. So some of my gear is already really good, but some of it is really bad, just as placeholder gear, since we are planning to do a lot of upgrades with Harvest Crafting. Just needed the characters to be able to farm it myself. So of course, first piece, Eternity Shroud. The main reason of this build, all my gear is Shaper. It gives 5% of elementals extra chaos damage, and you also ignore chaos resist on enemies. So as you see on my tooltip, obviously I'm 100% cold damage, and then all that extra chaos is from the Eternity Shroud. So there's quite a lot of damage added from it. Next, my weapons. This one's my best piece of gear on the whole character. The way I crafted this, I started with, I still have some, I think. So I still have some essences over here. This one, so it guarantees a tier 1 attack speed. So I pretty much just spam those essences on this, and I managed to actually hit tier 1 flat fizz and attack speed, and then a bunch of other mods, which we did end up removing. So I think we hit lightning res, fire res, and the three mods that you have here. So we did a remove lightning to get rid of the lightning res, and remove fire harvest craft to remove the fire res. And then we ended up with the three mod like this. Now I was originally gonna further craft this by doing a remove cold modifier to get rid of the fizz as extra cold. And then at that point you have a few options. You could technically meta craft this still with the harvest crafting. There's I did check out on PoEDB that I could technically in a long term guarantee percent hybrid fizz on this, since you can block the mana, the leech's mana, and all the other mods that you are able to get, you are able to remove as well with harvest crafting. So I could do that, or the other option, which was the easier one, was just augment it with cold again, which would either make me get fizz as extra cold again, which isn't the bad mod in this build, but I could also get flat cold, which is the ideal mod. I could just do that to get a high flat cold or high fizz as extra cold, and then just multi-mod it out. But for now, I just decided to stick with this like as it is now, because it is still a very good foil. And then the other one, mind you also that I got very lucky, by the way, with the essences, since I did hit the tier 1 flat fizz and attack speed in about 20 essences, and on PoE craft it does say on average is about 200 essences, so definitely on the lucky end there. Next, the other foil, got a bit less lucky on that one, since pretty much the same thing. I tried fossil crafting, I tried chaos spamming, but it's pretty hard to hit what I wanted. So I just went back to the essences, and I hit tier 4% fizz, which isn't great, but pretty much did the same thing again, got rid of all the other mods. And at that point, I multi-modded it and augmented it with a lucky physical mod, which we did hit the flat fizz, but it's only tier 5, unfortunately. But it's good enough for now. It's a 410 PDPS foil, but definitely a lot of room for improvement still. Those are weapons for now. The rest of the gear. So the helm, unfortunately, I wanted either a Frostblade enchant or a Blood Range enchant, but on a shape base, the availability is almost non-existent. So we managed to get this one, and I just put a few essences on it just to get resist and life pretty much, nothing special yet. So this is definitely going to get upgraded in the future. You can also go for a Star Conjas, but then you need to manage to get a helm with the Frostblade or Blood Rage enchant as a silken hood, and then chance it to a Star Conjas, which is another option you can do, but unfortunately there was no silken hoods with the enchant for now, so couldn't do that either. Next, the amulet. So pretty much bought the base. I think I fossiled it with jagged fossils. I'm not sure, I just tossed random fossils on it pretty much, and we hit the two crit modifiers that you see on here and the physics extra cold. And I think we had the random modifier on here, which was percent armor, which we removed with remove a defense modifier from harvest. And then we did augment it with a fizz modifier. Unfortunately, the flat fizz we hit is only tier 5. Unlucky, but at least it's a bit of damage. And then we just crafted life on this, so it's good enough for now. I actually just realized that again, I forgot to put my anoint on this, which we will do. The anoint we are going to go for is dismembering. So just some more crit and maim. Next is the rings. So I managed to get this ring, I think for one exalt, or was it two exalts? I can't actually remember, but pretty much just elemental damage with attacks, which is pretty nice damage, some flat fizz, life and resists. And then this other ring, I think was about 100 chaos, so just assassin's mark or curse. And we needed a bit of int, so we did get it on this ring. And then life, the cold damage to attacks isn't a lot of damage, but it's better than nothing, I suppose. And then we did craft some flat fizz on here. This still has an open suffix, so what I was planning to do was augment this with a fire or cold, whichever resist I need, and try and hit the resist on there. But I don't need it for now because my resist is capped. Next, the boots, very bad boots. Tier 4 life, which is less than crafted life even. Crafted movement speed, and I don't even have the correct movement speed craft. And then just some resists and tailwind. So pretty much just the worst tailwind boots you can find on the market. So for now, I guess I'll just use these, but these definitely are going to get upgraded. Gloves, I actually had these in my stash. They have life, a big resist, and a bit of attack speed. So it's not too bad, but definitely can still upgrade these as well. Most likely get an accuracy roll on here, higher attack speed, so that will be the upgrade here. And then belt, pretty expensive, but this is a very bad belt. Since the shaper base are like 4 exalts, so this is for the base, and then I just tossed some essences on this until I hit a bit of life and a bit of resist. So most of my gear, as you see, is pretty bad still. I just managed to cam my resists and get a decent life pool. And the damage is already fine enough. I will do a map showcase in a bit. So flasks, Dearest Promise, Taste of Hate, Lion's Roar. Most of our damage comes from these flasks. Diamond Flask, of course, since we're a crit build. And then a Quicksilver, which you can remove for something else, since we are leap slamming around, so you don't actually need a Quicksilver on this build, since you're not supposed to be running, you're just supposed to be leap slamming. And then the skill tree, so pretty generic. I mean, there's a lot of routes you can take with a build like this. Unfortunately, you need to travel to Duelist for the Sword Nose, the crit. And then we have two fights of survival, one with Corrupted Blood. And then that is it. I want to drop this dex node eventually, but for that I need dex on a piece of gear because I'm missing about 4 dexterity. And then just here, still have to fill out a few nodes, probably these two. And then probably this jewel socket and this jewel socket. And then we'll see what else we can grab. So for now, that's the skill tree, our lab. We're still missing our Uber lab, but we do have these nodes. This will be my Uber lab, so Rite of Ruin. Yeah, just a bit more speed and damage. And I guess lastly, the links. So Frostblades, Melee Fizz, Wed, Multi-Strike, Added Cold, and Hypothermia. Again, this isn't my ideal setup because I want to remove the edit cold, and I think I'd use Rootless, which is a red gem. Unfortunately, getting four red on this is a bit harder. But what I'm planning to do is once I get the harvest craft that turns a green socket into a red socket, I can swap my edit cold out for the Rootless support. Next, fortify faster attacks, blood magic, and leap slam. You can also use whirling blades. I was testing around which one I prefer more, but most likely leap slam is the better option. Herald of Ice, Hatred, Herald of Purity, and Enlighten. Now, unfortunately, you will need an Enlighten, I think, at least level 3. This one is just leveling, so I don't actually need it since we are not using our Herald of Purity currently. But once I get a level 3 or maybe even level 4 Enlighten, then we are able to use Herald of Purity as well. So if you don't have the mana, you don't have the Enlighten, just drop Herald of Purity. You'll still have enough damage. Ancestral Protector. Ice Golem, Maim, and Calling Strike. So just some call when we summon our totem, and also Maims for us. But once I do get my Anoint over here, we don't actually need the Maim, so I might look to using another gem there. And then Ice Golem, just a bit of extra crit and accuracy. And then here, cast on damage, MK, Mortal Coil. Can change whichever spell you want here. Steel Skin on Molten Shell works as well. And then Blood Rage, of course. Berserk, Enduring Cry, and Precision. And what I do with Enduring Cry, since on the skill tree we do take the instant War Cries over here, and then I put my Enduring Cry on my left click, so it will always cast on cooldown pretty much when I'm just moving around, doing anything. As long as you keep your left click hold in, it will always cast on cooldown. So that's a nice little trick. You don't need a life pod that way. You can also just actually bound it to another key and use it whenever you're low. So that's the character for now. Still a lot of upgrades to go. Just thought I'd share it for now. I'll put all of this in the path of building in case you want to play this build as well. And I'll leave you with the map showcase, and that will be it for now.